Hello, my friends, it's FPS-Russia again, and this is part two of our Top Shot extravaganza. If you haven't seen part one, there's a link below, but I got Dustin back with me, the winner of season three, and we're going to look at some of the weapons from season four of Top Shot, and why don't you tell us what we got there?
I tell you, this little space-age rifle here is pretty neat. This is the FS-2000, and it's a 5.56 bullpup. And it's a neat little package. It looks like it's straight out of Halo. Your chamber's all up here. Your rounds eject out the front. You got suppressor switch, all that. It's a nice little handy package. It just feels really nice.
That's one of my favorite rifles that FN makes. I just like it because it's a bullpup that actually a right-handed person or a left-handed person can use, and you don't get the shell spraying in your face. I shoot both ways, so I like that one a lot.
It's a neat looking gun.
Check this thing out.
All right. Oh yeah, this is your Mossberg new chainsaw shotgun. I think it was mostly designed for either zombie killing or breaching. I'm not sure, but it's definitely got a cool look to it.
Maybe breaching doors to kill zombies.
There we go. That's how you do it. So I'm looking forward to see how Top Shot fits this into the show, because that's going to be some creative challenge there.
I haven't seen the show yet. I don't know exactly what they're going to do, but something difficult will be shooting targets out of the air. I might try some of that.
There you go.
Okay, so now that we know a little bit about the guns, once again, it's time to have some fun. Okay, so once again, we've had Dustin go get into the bunker, make sure he stays safe, and now we're going to do some shooting. I got my Mossberg 500 chainsaw gun here. They call it the chainsaw gun because obviously this handle on top, it's meant for grabbing this, pressing against the door, and, you know, blowing the locks off. It's called door breaching, and normally you wouldn't use it for what we're going to do with it. We're going to shoot some sporting clays, so I'm going to try to get a camera angle so you can see everything, and let's see what we can do. So that's not exactly what this shotgun is designed for. Let me show you what it's designed for. Door breaching. Okay, so like I said, the Mossberg chainsaw is built for breaching doors, so let's breach a door. The best part is, like the AA-12 I've shown before, it's got teeth here. They're meant to bite in the door so you don't slip off, so you can pop the lock. So you see it knocks the lock completely out of the door, and then you switch to something special for these guys. So let's go over there, and I'll show you what the different shells did to the targets, even though we knocked that one completely off. Okay, so the first target we shot with buckshot, so you've got the big pellets all over the place, and a lot of people like to use buckshot for home defense, but the thing is, if you're doing it for home defense, how far away is your target going to be? You're not going to be shooting 50 meters, you're going to be shooting about what we shot, the length of the room. So let me show you what the birdshot did. Okay, so this is what birdshot does to something up close. You see how big the pattern is? This is what you want for home defense. That way it doesn't go through drywall and doors, hurt someone you don't want to hurt. Lots of people, like I said, use buckshot, slugs, things like that. That is not the way to go. You've got a tremendous amount of force and a nice spread if you use birdshot. So let me show you what our specialty round did. Okay, so on this one, we shot it twice with dragon's breath. Lots of people asked about dragon's breath. But basically, you've got a very flammable metal flake, and you've got shot also in there. So it's got half the effect of the birdshot we just used, but it also sets your target on fire, and who doesn't like that? It, as you saw, it was burning there for a while, and you can see all the way around where it singed. It's not really practical. It will scare the shit out of someone, but it is cool stuff to play with. So that's the Mossberg. Let's move on to our next weapon. Okay, so this is our FS-2000. As we mentioned, it's a bullpup, and for those who don't know, that basically means your trigger group is back here, and behind your right hand, your shooting hand. And what I like about the bullpups, you have the long barrel because it's coming all the way back to here, but you've got the short barrel profile, makes it very pointable. And what I really like about this one in particular is the ejection port is up here. That's where the empty holes come out. And the problem with a lot of bullpups is if you're left-handed, and you're firing like this, the ejection port will be right here, throwing brass in your face. But with this, it's just spilling out here. You can shoot righty or lefty, just switch. You don't have to worry about swapping things over like you would with an AUG. I like the FS-2000. So, got the target down there at about 50 meters. I'm gonna shoot a group. I got my aim point on this one. It's pretty good optics, so let's see what we can do. Okay, let's go down, take a look at what we did. I think it's going to be pretty good. Okay, so as you can see, even at 50 meters, you can put up a pretty good pattern out of this rifle. That's why I like the bullpups. Like I said, you've got the full-length barrel in here. It's pretty damn accurate. Let's have some fun. Okay, so there's no real challenge or skill to this, but I know you guys like Tracer, and I sure as hell love Tracer, so let's see what it looks like. Tracer puts on a better show than pretty much anything we play with. Let's do something a little bit more serious though. Okay, so one more thing with the F2000. I had to get a nice fiery explosion in there, so let's see what we can do. I love mushroom clouds. When you get the mushroom clouds, you know you did a good job. Let's go check in with Dustin. Okay, so I had a lot of fun with these guns. I especially liked that shotgun. That was a lot of fun to play with. Just want to thank you for coming on. Did you want to tell us a little bit about the next season of Top Shot?
Yes, sir. Season 4 of Top Shot will premiere on February 14th at 10 and 9 Central on History. And so just thanks for letting me come out and show off the new toys, man.
Once again, we appreciate you coming. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And as always, have a nice day.